A suspected Mexican drug gang leader could walk away free, even though authorities accuse him of hundreds of murders, maybe thousands, including a United States consulate worker and an officer from Texas. Police arrested this man in 2010 in Juarez, Mexico, a city near the Texas border that really is riddled with cartel violence. It's really in the news almost daily. Prosecutors say he was involved in the shooting deaths of three people linked to the United States consulate there. Two of the victims seen here were married. The wife worked for the consulate. The husband was an officer at the El Paso Detention Center. Authorities say the couple was leaving a party in Juarez back in March of 2010 when gunmen opened fire on their SUV. They report the couple's baby, who was in the back seat, was not hurt. Police say hours later, gunmen killed the husband of another U.S. consulate worker. Authorities last year extradited the suspect to the U.S., where he's now awaiting trial. But he claims officers in Mexico brutally tortured him and forced him to confess to the consulate killings. Now his attorneys want the court here to throw out that confession. Drew Finley joins us now with more. And Drew is a criminal defense attorney. Drew, I'm curious. The judge has said that they will not set aside this confession. It is definitely going to happen in court. So doesn't that put this to bed?
No, it really doesn't. There are two ways to look at this situation. One is, are you able to suppress it? That is, were the lawyers able to convince the judge that the voluntariness of the confession, the incriminating statement made in 2010 to Mexican authorities, was not reliable because of alleged torture? The judge said, no, it can come in and it will be set forth in front of a jury through live testimony. Now the lawyers can say to the jury, hey, look, the jury's not going to know about the hearing in front of the judge, of course, unless they watch it on Fox News right now. They're going to say, hey, you can't rely on this statement because of torture. They're going to put in evidence of the 2010 presidency of President Calderon and how much he needed this arrest and how it helps him in his relationship with his own voters, let alone the United States. He conceded to allowing the torture take place. It's unreliable. Don't consider it. Only go on what other evidence there is, and they allege there's not enough evidence to convict outside of the confession.
You know, some of the details in this are hard to hear. I mean, I've read specifics about the torture that he says he endured and the fact that, according to him and his wife, she was raped during this whole confession gathering. Does it matter in our legal system, though, what happened to this man, his wife, in another country at the hands of another government to get him to talk?
Well, apparently to this judge, it didn't matter regarding the issue of whether or not the confession was voluntary. It may matter to 12 people sitting on a jury when they say, hey, can we really rely on this statement if this guy and his wife were tortured? Because remember, the confession is unfathomable. How could somebody actually order the murder of not tens, not hundreds, but thousands of people? I mean, it almost doesn't make sense, and it may let a jury say, you know what, it's so large, the magnitude is so out of control that it may just be fiction as a result of brutal torture.
You know, I've seen you at it, so I want to ask, put yourself in the shoes real quickly of the defense attorneys and maybe just the top talking points that you would make with this judge that you think will be home runs.
Well, I think that I would talk about the craziness of the numbers. There are some numbers that are just impossible to imagine. When we think sometimes about crazy people that allege, they walk into a police department and they say, hey, I'm responsible for hundreds and thousands of murders. Good homicide detectives know that's impossible. Was it really possible that he did this, that he ordered the killing of so many people? It's almost too much. And how does it get to be too much? It gets to be too much when you do things like electronically sent impulses into somebody's private parts and other things that are alleged to have taken place here, or rape one's spouse. Things like that can make somebody say anything, even something that's completely fiction.
Drew Finley, defense attorney, thank you very much for your time.
Absolutely.
Of course, we'll keep everybody posted on this case. When it makes news, we'll let you know. Speaking of what's going on south of the border now with drug cartels,